Is that Yeah. the Lord. Hallelujah. We serve a mighty God. We serve an awesome God. We serve a wonderful God. He's a creator. He's the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Had it not been for the goodness of the Lord, we are here today under an open heaven, worshiping the Lord for what He has done for us. We were able to successfully start and complete our 7th annual 100 days of prayer. And that's something to give God thanks and praise for. And so today we have built our altars. Our altars of thanksgiving is built. And it is built unto the Lord. We have built our altars of thanksgiving in anticipation for what is coming. The blessings that are coming. The miracles that are coming. The favor that is coming. The healing that is coming. And the breakthrough that is coming. And so we have built our altars unto the Lord as a testimony of thanksgiving. Whenever Abraham embarked on a new journey, whenever Abraham was called out by the Lord to do something, every single time Abraham accomplished a certain leg in his journey, he stopped and he built an altar. It's very important that we never wait until we get to where we are going to stop and build an altar. Every single time you attain some form of victory in your life, no matter how small it is, you stop and build an altar. And so we have stopped. Our 100 days of prayer is complete. We began by building an altar. All through the 100 days of prayer, we were doing thanksgivings and different things. And now we have completed another cycle in the 100 days of prayer. And we have stopped to build an altar. And so I have a word from the Lord for every person that participated in the 100 days of prayer. For every person, every minister that prayed in the 6 a.m. watch. Every person that is online, you prayed with us. I have a word for you from the Lord today concerning coming out of the 100 days of prayer. Ephesians chapter 3 and verse 20. I want to give us this prophetic word, and then we're going to do some other special things that we have prepared for you today. Let's get Ephesians 3 and 20 ready.
Amen.
Go ahead, read if you have it.
Now unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly, according to the power that worketh in us. I'll read it again. Now unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us.
Amen. Now God is getting ready to do some amazing things in your life in this season. We are beginning a new month, the month of May. And God is preparing you. He's preparing you. He's preparing me for what he is getting ready to bring forth in your life. According to Ephesians 3 and 20, now unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can ask or think, but according to the power that works in you. So the things that the Lord is getting ready to do is exceeding, it's abundant, it's magnificent, but it's according to the power that worketh in you. Let's all pray this prayer. Let's be seated, if we can, and let's pray this prayer right now. I'm waiting for the pastor to be seated. Let's close our eyes and let's say this prayer. Say, dear Lord, I'm here today to receive the word of the Lord for my next level. Open up my heart to hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. Make me a receiver of this word today. Let me leave with the anointing dripping from this altar, that I can come into manifestation. In Yeshua's name. So we are coming out of a prayer womb of 100 days. What are we coming out of? A prayer womb. Do you know when a baby is in a womb for 9 months? After 9 months, something happens. The mother begins to feel birthing pains, attractions. And then the water breaks. Someone said the water breaks.
Water breaks.
This week, at this headquarters, something very prophetic happened. On Wednesday, when we came out here to have Wednesday prayer, it was lots of rain. Thunder showers. It was thunder showers. Global Church, some of you all will remember. We posted the video where the region was flooding and the streets were flooding. Thunder showers, lightning, rain all day. Many places were flooding out. But something very prophetic happened. Some of the pastors that were here on Wednesday service, they called me to say, Apostle, there is something broken or leaking at the top of a certain wall. And water was just leaking from that wall, leaking and running down. And they were busy taking care of that water and all of that. And reported it to the maintenance team, and they're going to take care of that for us. But while I was in prayer Wednesday night, the Lord said to me, that's a prophetic sign of the water breaking as the people of God are coming out of the womb. You're coming out of a womb, and the water breaking, which means that you're leaving one season of your life and you're coming into a whole new season as the water breaks. And so that water prophetess that was running down that wall is a prophetic indication of the water bag that broke over this ministry. We're coming into a season of manifestation. We're coming into a season of miracles. We are coming into a season, one of the most significant seasons that we have ever been in. And so I'm preparing you now for your greatness. I am preparing you for where the Lord is taking you. Because I want you to understand something. You do not just pray for 100 days and come out empty-handed. You got to come out with results. You got to come out carrying something. You got to come out prepared to go somewhere. And so the prophetic word of the Lord is coming to you today. We are coming out of a prayer womb of 100 days. The water has broken. And the Spirit of the Lord is pushing us out of the old into the new. An old chapter is closing. An old season is closing. And we are now being birthed out into a season of manifestation and miracles. Somebody say manifestation.
manifestation
and miracles. You are coming forth on eagle's wings. You are coming forth with new power, new might, new vision, new grace, new energy, new wisdom. The sons and daughters of God are about to be manifested in a new and fresh way. Do I have a church that is ready to come forth in a new and fresh way? It's a new anointing for a new season. It's a new power for a new day. So you are coming forth on eagle's wings with new power, new might, new vision, new grace, and new energy. How many people need the energy of the Lord today? Do you need the energy of the Lord today? When you're in the right place at the right time to receive an outpouring from heaven, the energy of the Lord, the anointing of God, the power of God, the favor of God is about to be poured out upon this house. I want you to open up your heart to receive.
I receive.
You better receive. The sons and daughters of God are about to be manifested in a new and fresh way. It's new, it's fresh, it's anointed, and it's authentic. Tell someone it's anointed and it's authentic. It's anointed and it's authentic. It's new, it's fresh, it's anointed, and it's authentic. Let's repeat that one more time. I want those words, the spirit of those words, to go down the inside of what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. It's new.
It's new.
It's fresh.
It's fresh.
It's anointed.
It's anointed.
It's authentic.
It's authentic.
It's new.
It's new.
It's fresh.
It's fresh.
It's anointed.
It's anointed.
It's authentic.
It's authentic.
Can nobody see what you're getting ready to bring forth? Because it belongs to you. You've navigated the realms of the Spirit during the 100 days of prayer. You went into the enemy camp and you took back what belongs to you. And so now I want the house to get ready to snatch what belongs to you. I want you to snatch what belongs to you. It's fresh. It's anointed. It's authentic. Do you know what the Lord said to me? He said, Anna, what the church is getting ready to bring forth in this hour, the Lord gave me a word for it. And he said, I want you to call it an authentic kingdom manifestation. It's an authentic kingdom manifestation. It's an authentic kingdom manifestation. It's an authentic kingdom manifestation. child.
It's coming.
It's coming.
It's coming.
It's coming. Your authentic kingdom manifestation. It's coming. It's coming and it's going to be amazing. It's coming and it's going to be mighty. It cannot be stopped. It cannot be hindered. It cannot be copied. It is a new you coming forth into your glorious future. You are stepping into the future that you pray for. The future that you have been dreaming about. The future that you've been believing the Lord for. You're stepping into your glorious future. May your eyes be open to see it. May your eyes be open to see it. For your feet can never take you where your mind has never been. May your eyes be open to see the revelation of heaven concerning your glorious future. May your eyes be open. May your eyes be open. May the Lord grant you prophetic eyesight. Prophetic eyesight. Prophetic eyesight. Prophetic eyesight. To see the vision of the Lord. For it's about to be manifest. It's about to be manifest. The vision of the Lord is about to be manifest. It's coming. Awaken. May your eyes be open to see the prophetic realm of where God is taking you. It's a new level, it's a new season. It's a new level, it's a new season. It's a new level, it's a new season, prophetess. Do I have a church in the house? It's a new level, it's a new season. It's a new anointing that's coming. Let the dream be awakened once more. Let the dream be awakened out of your womb once more. For you planted it. You planted it in the 100 days. You planted it in the 100 days. The Spirit of the Lord impregnated you in the 100 days. And now it's time to bring forth. Now it's time to bring forth. Now it's time to bring forth. The new anointing in the earth. Let the dream come forth. Let the I said it's time to plant the dream. Do I have a people in this The devil have tried to weary the saints now. You're required to wake up now. Let the church lift your hands. The Spirit of the Lord is here. And He's pouring fresh oil. We see fresh oil. Fresh oil. Fresh oil in your life. We see fresh oil. Fresh anointing. Be released on your life. Receive. 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 Receive that fresh oil. Those of you receive, 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 receive. I want you to receive it, receive it, receive it. As the Spirit of the Lord, I'm playing this song over you. Receive from the Holy Spirit. Receive that fresh anointing. Receive that new power. Receive that new energy. Some people are weak. Some people are Spirit. Your future is calling you. You better answer. Tell someone you better answer. You better answer. Your future is calling you. Your future is calling you, Lord Church. You better answer. Because it's time for miracles and manifestation.
Impregnated you with during the 100 days of prayer. Some of you
Your in who cattle has come today. Receive the oil to build the tree. The millionaire woman anointing comes upon your life today. I bless you in Yeshua's name. Chapter Samaru, thank you for running your leg in this 100 days of prayer. The Lord bless you. Thursday mornings. going as a sacrifice, to get up, to prepare yourself so that you have to take care of your elderly mom, cook food, clean house, and other things. But you did it faithfully. And the Lord is going to reward you. This oil is a dream oil. This oil is going to anoint your coming Boaz. I bless you with this oil. The Lord is going to bring you back because He's a faithful God. He never disappoints the righteous. He never disappoints His people. It's part of finishing your earthly assignments. I bless you today. Put the dream. I bless you today with this oil of manifestation. I bless your house of prayer. I bless your heart, your life. I bless your son, Abdiel. Every time you had to get up to run your prayer marathon on the Monday mornings, you got up and you ran your leg faithfully. You prayed for the people of the Caribbean. And so I bless you, Louisiana House of Prayer, with the oil of manifestation. You're going to build the dream. You're getting ready to cross territories. Your homestead is coming. this is the anointing and the power to bring forth the dream. And so I bless you, kingdom prosperity, wealth and resources, to birth the dream in Yeshua's name. And let's go on to the blessing of the altar. dream. Remember, I gave you the acronym for dream. You are delivering D. You're delivering your royal, exquisite, authentic manifestation. That's your dream C. Your dream C is coming forth in the end. Put out that dream in her heart. Give her her heart's desire. In Yeshua's name. Amen.
Healing on hands today. Father, we bind.